Well, good afternoon, and welcome to all of you from wherever you are joining us for our annual Good Friday service here at Highland Park United Methodist Church. Our service today will consist of music and spoken word that is designed to be participatory. The readings and songs will take us from the prophetic anticipation of Christ through his passion on Good Friday. So as we move through the service, you're encouraged to join in the readings on the bottom of the screen and the hymns as they are displayed there. I'm joined today by the Reverend Joe Stabile and by members of Highland Park United Methodist Church Chancel Choir, and it is our prayer today that you will be blessed in this solemn time of worship. And so I invite you to join me in our call to worship. And this is the judgment: that the light has come into the world, and we loved darkness rather than light.
God is light, in whom there is no darkness at all.
God sent the Son into the world, not to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him.
Everyone who does evil hates the light, and does not come to the light, but all who do what is true come to the light.
Come, let us worship in spirit and in truth. Be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray together. Most gracious God, look with mercy upon your family gathered here, on whom our Lord Jesus Christ was betrayed, given into sinful hands, and suffered death upon the cross. Strengthen our faith and forgive our betrayals as we enter the way of his passion. Through him who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. See, my servant shall prosper. He shall be exalted and lifted up and shall be very high. Just as there were many who were astonished at him, so marred was his appearance beyond human semblance, and his form beyond that of mortals. So he shall startle many nations. Kings shall shut their mouths because of him. For that which had not been told them, they shall see. And that which they had not heard, they shall contemplate. Who has believed what we have heard? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up before him like a young plant and like a root out of dry ground. He had no form or majesty that we should look at him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by others, a man of suffering and acquainted with infirmity. And as one from whom others hide their faces, he was despised, and we held him of no account. Surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases, yet we accounted him stricken, struck down by God and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole, and by his bruises we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have all turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep that before its shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By a perversion of justice he was taken away. Who could have imagined his future? For he was cut off from the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people. They made his grave with the wicked and his tomb with the rich, although he had done no violence and there was no deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the will of the Lord to crush him with pain. When you make his life an offering for sin, he shall see offspring and shall prolong his days. Through him the will of the Lord shall prosper. Out of his anguish he shall see light. He shall find satisfaction through his knowledge. The righteous one, my servant, shall make many righteous, and he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore, I will allot him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he poured out himself to death and was numbered with the transgressors. Yet he bore the sin of many and made intercession for the transgressors.
Oh,
from Psalm 22. My God, why have you forsaken me? Why are you so far from helping me, from the words of my groaning? Oh, my God, I cry by day, but you do not answer, and by night, but find no rest. Yet you are holy, enthroned on the praises of Israel. In you our ancestors trusted. They trusted and you delivered them. To you they cried and were saved. In you they trusted and were not put to shame.
Not human, scorned by others and despised by the people. All who see me mock at me. They make mouths at me. They shake their heads. Commit your cause to the Lord. Let him deliver. Let him rescue the one in whom he delights. Yet it was you who took me from the womb. You kept me safe on my mother's breast. On you I was cast from my birth, and since my mother bore me, you have been my God. Do not be far from me, for trouble is near, and there is no one to help. I will tell of your name to my brothers and sisters. In the midst of the congregation, I will praise you. You who fear the Lord, praise him. All you offspring of Jacob, glorify him. Stand in awe of him, all you offspring of Israel. For he did not despise or abhor the affliction of the afflicted. He did not hide his face from me, but heard when I cried to him.
From you comes my praise in the great congregation. My vows I will pay before those who fear him. The poor shall eat and be satisfied. Those who seek him shall praise the Lord. May your hearts live forever. All the ends of the earth shall remember and turn to the Lord, and all the families of the nations shall worship before him. For dominion belongs to the Lord, and he rules over the nations. To him indeed shall all who sleep in the earth bow down. Before him shall bow all who go down to the dust, and I shall live for him.
Thank you.
The Passion of Jesus Christ according to John. Jesus went forth with his disciples across the Kidron Valley, where there was a garden, which he and his disciples entered. Now Judas, who betrayed him, also knew the place, for Jesus often met there with his disciples. So Judas, procuring a band of soldiers and some officers from the chief priests and the Pharisees, went there with lanterns and torches and weapons. Then Jesus, knowing all that was to befall him, came forward and said to them,
"Whom do you seek?"
They answered him, "Jesus of Nazareth." And Jesus said to them,
"I am he."
Judas, who betrayed him, was standing with them. And when he said to them, "I am he," they drew back and fell to the ground. Again he asked them,
"Whom do you seek?"
And they said, "Jesus of Nazareth."
"I told you that I am he. So if you seek me, let these men go."
This was to fulfill the word which he had spoken, "I did not lose a single one of those whom you gave me." Then Simon Peter, having a sword, drew it and struck the high priest's slave and cut off his ear. The slave's name was Malchus. Jesus said to Peter,
"Put your sword into its sheath. Shall I not drink the cup which the Father has given me?"
Soldiers and their captain and the officers of the Judean authority seized Jesus and bound him. First, they led him to Annas, for he was the father-in-law of Caiaphas, who was the high priest that year. It was Caiaphas who had given counsel to the religious authorities that it was expedient that one man should die for the people.
Simon Peter followed Jesus, and so did another disciple. As this disciple was known to the high priest, he entered the court of the high priest along with Jesus, while Peter stood outside at the door. So the other disciple, who was known to the high priest, went out and spoke to the women who guarded the gate and brought Peter in. The woman who guarded the gate said to Peter,
"Are not you also one of this man's disciples?" And he said,
"I am not."
Now the servants and the officers had made a charcoal fire because it was cold, and they were standing and warming themselves. Peter also was with them, standing and warming himself. The high priest then questioned Jesus about his disciples and his teaching. Jesus answered him,
"I've spoken openly to the world. I've always taught in synagogues and in the temple, where all Jewish people come together. I've said nothing secretly. Why do you ask me? Ask those who have heard me what I said to them. They know what I said."
When he had said this, one of the officers standing by struck Jesus with his hand, saying, "Is that how you answer the high priest?"
"If I have spoken wrongly, bear witness to the wrong. But if I have spoken rightly, why do you strike me?"
Annas then sent him bound to Caiaphas, the high priest.
Simon Peter was standing and warming himself. They said to him,
"Are not you also one of his disciples?"
He denied it and said,
"I am not."
One of the servants of the high priest, a kinsman of the man whose ear Peter had cut off, asked,
"Did I not see you in the garden with him?"
Peter again denied it, and at once the cock crowed. Then they led Jesus from the house of Caiaphas to Pilate's headquarters. It was early. They themselves did not enter the headquarters so that they might not be defiled, but might eat the Passover. So Pilate went out to them and said,
"What accusation do you bring against this man?"
"If this man were not an evildoer, we would not have handed him over."
Pilate said to them,
"Take him yourselves and judge him by your own law."
The religious authorities said to him,
It is not lawful for us to put any man to death.
This was to fulfill the word which Jesus had spoken, to show by what death he was to die.
Jesus was thy incarnation.
entered the headquarters again and called to Jesus and said to him, "Are you the king of the Jews?"
"Do you say this of your own accord, or did others say it to you about me?"
"Am I a Jew? Your own nation and the chief priests have handed you over to me. What have you done?"
"My kingship is not of this world. If my kingship were of this world, my servants would fight that I might not be handed over to the religious authorities. But my kingship is not from the world."
"So you're a king?"
"You say that I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I have come into the world, to bear witness to the truth. Everyone who is of the truth hears my voice."
"What is truth?" After Pilate said this, he went to the religious authorities again and told them, "I find no crime in him, but you have a custom that I should release one man to you at the Passover. Will you have me release for you the king of the Jews?" And they cried out again,
"Not this man, but Barabbas."
Now, Barabbas was a robber. Then Pilate took Jesus and scourged him, and the soldiers plaited a crown of thorns and put it on his head, and they arrayed him in a purple robe, and they came up to him saying, "Hail, King of the Jews," and struck him with their hands. Pilate went out again and said to them, "See, I am bringing him out to you that you may know that I find no crime in him." So Jesus came out wearing the crown of thorns and the purple robe, and Pilate said to them, "Behold the man." When the chief priests and the officers saw him, they cried out,
"Crucify him! Crucify him!"
And Pilate said to them, "Take him yourselves and crucify him, for I find no crime in him." The religious authorities answered him, "We have a law, and by that law he ought to die, because he has made himself the Son of God." When Pilate heard these words, he was the more afraid. He entered the headquarters again and said to Jesus, "Where are you from?" But Jesus gave no answer. Pilate therefore said to him, "You will not speak to me? Do you not know that I have the power to release you and the power to crucify you?"
"You would have no power over me unless it had been given you from above. Therefore, he who delivered me to you has the greater sin."
Mine was the transgressor.
Upon this, Pilate sought to release him, but the religious authorities cried out, "If you release this man, you are not Caesar's friend. Everyone who makes himself a king sets himself against Caesar." When Pilate heard these words, he brought Jesus out and sat down on the judgment seat at a place called the pavement, and in Hebrew, Gabbatha. Now, it was the day of preparation of the Passover. It was about the sixth hour. He said to the religious authorities, "Behold your king." And they cried out, "Away with him! Away with him! Crucify him!" And Pilate said to them, "Shall I crucify your king?" The chief priests answered, "We have no king but Caesar." They handed him over to be crucified.
What language shall I borrow to thank thee, dearest friend, for this thy dying sorrow?
So they took Jesus out, bearing his own cross, to the place they called the place of the skull, which is called in Hebrew, Golgotha. There they crucified him, and with him two others, one on either side, and Jesus between them. Pilate also wrote a title and put it on the cross. It read, "Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews." Many of the Judeans read this title, for the place where Jesus was crucified was near the city, and it was written in Hebrew, in Latin, and in Greek. The Jewish chief priests then said to Pilate, "Do not write the King of the Jews, but this man said, 'I am King of the Jews.'" Pilate answered, "What I have written, I have written."
Cup was filled with darkness. Our cup was filled with death. Christ took our cup and drank it, and gave us life, and gave us hope, gave us night, we hear him.
When the soldiers had crucified Jesus, they took his garments and made four parts, one for each soldier, also his tunic. But the tunic was without seam, woven from top to bottom. So they said to one another, "Let us not tear it, but cast lots for it to see whose it shall be." This was to fulfill the scripture, "They parted my garments among them, and for my clothing they cast lots." So the soldiers did this, but standing by the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister, Mary, wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing near her, he said to his mother,
"Woman, behold your son."
Then he said to the disciple,
"Behold your mother."
And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. After this, Jesus, knowing that all was now finished, said to fulfill the scripture,
"I thirst."
A bowl full of vinegar stood there, so they put a sponge of vinegar on hyssop and held it to his mouth. When Jesus had received the vinegar, he said,
"It is finished."
And he bowed his head and gave up his spirit.
Crucified my causes me to tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they nailed him to a tree? Were you there when they nailed him to a tree? Crucified.